Hello everybody, I'm Michael from Mike at Work, and I'm here to show you my attempt at trying to fix this Roomba 537. It has come to me with a fault. Well, it's completely dead, so the Roomba itself is unresponsive, and putting it on the docking station, the red light starts flashing very fast and you get an error, charging error number 3. So looking online quickly, doing my research, when you have a charging error number 3, people tend to target the main board as where the fault is. It's not actually the battery itself. But being this is already now a couple of years old, I believe it was released in 2007, and this is 2024 when I'm recording this video. So it's quite a few years old. So the battery, if it was the original one, wasn't mine originally. If someone gave this to me, I picked it up free. Then, you know, the battery is well and truly going to be cactus by now. So we should really suspect the battery. But anyway, we're going to disassemble the unit and have a look at the main board, and also going to poke around and take apart the battery. We'll start to disassemble the battery and start to inspect it and look for faults around the battery. I'm not going to show you how I'm disassembling this Roomba. You can find those very, very easily by looking at other wonderful YouTube videos of others. I'm going to jump straight to the disassembled Roomba and what I'm going to do to investigate the faults on the main board and in the battery. So let's see what we can find. This is the Roomba in its disassembled state. Looking at it like this makes me less worried that the robots are going to take over us humans. Okay, so now it's pulled apart. Let's first have a look at the battery.
So what I've done is I've taken the shrink wrap packaging off to try and debug the battery, originally thinking that this was the culprit. Reading 0 volts, I checked all the voltage across all the cells. There's 3 or 4 of them that were reading 0, so I'm reading a couple of volts. But giving a slight triple charge on my power supply, it's actually come back up to 14 volts. And it might actually be enough to at least check if the fix has done the job, and if the battery still can do something. I suspect after being flat for so long, these cells are probably irreversibly damaged. Anyway, but I've also got to put this thing back together, and you can see I've put these 2 screws as contacts into here so I can use my alligator clips to clip those up to my power supply and get it charged up to about 14.5 volts.
So this is the R3 main electronics PCB, as it has written here. And reading online, they talk about the FETs, or the MOSFETs, being damaged or suspect, specifically Q17 and Q18, which is Q17's there and Q18's there. And then if you read more online on the forums, you find out that people find that they actually are not problematic at all, or not faulty at all. So I decided I'd test them. So so we just go across the drain and the source across here, which should be right. These are P-channel MOSFETs. So you can see it's working in the forward diode current. So it's showing something there and nothing in the direction, which is what you want to see. We'll try the next one. So this is Q18. That's showing about 2 volts, which might be suspicious. And in reverse, we're seeing about 0.5 volt, which is actually more specified, which is actually what's specified for the diode that's across the drain and the source. So this 2 volts may or may not be the MOSFET. And I actually have tested these properly by using a battery to provide some voltage to about 6 volts to the gate, and they actually switch, and so I would not suspect these 2 MOSFETs. And then the other parts to check, so people have mentioned the diodes have been suspicious. I've checked all the diodes on the other side. They all test fine in situ, nothing to be suspicious about there. I've also checked these 2 resistors, and plus there's nothing about either those resistors or anything here that shows there's any kind of a burnout. That would be something that would direct us to what might be faulty with this board. So now I can also check these 2 diodes. So these 2 diodes is one here and one over here. These are Schottky diodes. This one is D13, so I'll just test it now. And that's showing, actually can't tell which way around is the anode and the cathode, but anyway, we'll just check one way around. This one is showing no current. If we try to swap the leads around, we get about 0.3 of a volt. That's about what you'd expect with the diode. Let's try D1, 1.6, and just try to remember what this one was. If saying, okay, so you get something. They're both around the same way. Nothing that way, and something that way. So let's try that over here. So that one shows 1.6 volts. And if you try in reverse, we also get 1.6 volts. When you might expect to get more at the diode we give you, which is 0.3. That's actually quite interesting. Okay. So that measure confirms the diode is faulty, so we better take it out. So in order to do that, I'm going to use this hot air desolder unit for SMDs. So once it gets hot, I'll start desoldering and speed up the video, and we'll take it out. Got it out, now let's test it. This is the other way around. Oh, okay. This diode is not working. Rummaging through my leftover semiconductors tray, transistors and diodes here, raided from dead appliances and some spares left over from prior projects. I found this guy here. It turns out it's a 1N5822, which is a, I believe, if I remember correctly, is a 3 amp rated 40 volt Schottky diode. This guy was 60 volt. Now, I'm not sure if 60 volt ever appears in this board, being that the power supply is 20 or so volts and the battery is 14. So it might just do the trick. As you can see, it's getting a bit of a tricky effort to squeeze it in there, but at least before going out and spending money or any more time on this, it'll certainly tell us if it works. Okay, let's solder it in using my normal soldering iron. Here is my handiwork with getting that diode into place. As you can see, it's taking up a lot more space than the other diode, hence why they would have gone for this SMD type, which is just down there. But it'll test okay, there's no shorts, so this is looking good to go back in. We'll see if this doesn't get in the way of anything, and we'll see if this Roomba will come back to life. The Roomba will Roomba again. Let's go.
Seeing as that this fix looks like it might work, if you call it a fix, maybe it was just the battery, I've just ordered a new battery online, so when that arrives, we can confirm completely that maybe it was the battery all along, or if it was that diode has fixed it. But anyway, ultimately that it's fixed the Roomba. Okay.
Looks like this Roomba is going to work, and therefore can justify buying a new battery for it. I think the diodes were actually not responsible for the fault, because they were, will appear to me as protection diodes. Well, at least they blow the fuse if there's a reverse polarity on the docking station or the power supply. So it looks actually more like it was just the battery. So I've got a new one, and recovering the old one has helped. So that's been a good fix. Thank you very much for watching, and good luck with your Roomba too.